Hi, my name is James Storm. I'm a senior product manager here at D2L, and I'm here today to tell you about our new offering for content management within Brightspace called Lessons. Now, Lessons is designed for teachers to make it as easy as possible to manage the content of your course. It offers a number of nice ways to move content around, look at pacing, see how your content is aligned to standards, because we know that is very important for teachers to know that they're teaching the right standards so they set their students up for the greatest amount of success. So let's look at how we can look at the new Lessons interface in Brightspace. So here we see the fifth grade math course homepage. And the teacher here can look at the content by simply clicking on content, and they will be greeted with the new, easy to use and colorful Lessons content management interface. Down the left-hand side of the screen, we see how all of the course content is organized into very familiar units and lessons and materials. We see the units at the top level, and we can dig into each level and see the lessons inside of each unit. And inside of each lesson, we can see the course materials that have been assigned to this particular lesson. It's very, very easy for a teacher to rearrange the content by using simple drag and drop. If for some reason they wanted to put lesson two before lesson three, or after lesson three, it's very, very simple. Adding materials to Brightspace now is very, very simple, and there's a number of new options. So to add new material to lessons, the teacher can select from these five particular options in this first release. We have Google Drive, and you can also pick from existing activities in the course, such as assignments and quizzes and discussions, and the teacher can also upload content directly from their desktop. But the integration I really wanted to highlight today is the Google Drive integration. So we've made it really simple for the teacher to grab things from either their personal or their Google Classroom Drive to add to the course. In this case, the teacher wants to augment the course with an extra worksheet for her students in this particular unit on multiplication. So she simply grabs the document and clicks select, and there we go. The document is automatically loaded within the context of the course, right for the teacher to see. And this could be a live document that the teacher's still working on, but once the teacher's ready, she can make this available to students. You see at the top, it is currently hidden from students, so the one thing she needs to do is to make it visible. Now, when students visit this course, they will see this new multiplication worksheet ready for them to work on in order to prepare for an upcoming quiz, let's say. The other nice integration is the ability to post to the course homepage. So it's very easy for the teacher, once they've added it to the two lessons, they can now broadcast it to all the students within the new activity feed feature. One of the really important things for teachers to understand is how all the content in their classes align to learning standards. And so we provide nice visualizations for the teacher to see how all the content in the course aligns to the standards that have been prescribed. So a school district or a school board will set the standards that need to be taught in particular classes, and then they can put together a course with content and they can do alignments. And then in this visualization, we can see for each alignment, for each standard, we can see how each unit aligns and how many pieces of content there are for each standard in the course. This is really important because it gives a teacher really high confidence that the course that they've got here to teach is going to hit all the things that they need to impart to the students so they can pass standardized tests and be as successful as possible at the end of the school year. Another thing I'd like to show you is the automated pacing. So based on content durations that may come in a common cartridge package, Brightspace Lessons here can make an educated guess as to when each unit should start. So the teacher's in Lessons, they can see that the start dates for each of these units here. And these aren't etched in stone, right? We know teachers will know better often than an algorithm when things should start. So of course the teachers can go in and edit the dates either for the course or even for the unit itself. They can rename the unit and can then also change the date if they don't like the automatically generated start date for the unit. So we give a lot of the automated guidance for teachers, but of course the ability for them to exercise their own professional judgment is there as well. We really hope you're going to enjoy using Lessons in your blended K-12 classrooms, and we're excited to hear your feedback. And we'll see you in Brightspace community to have an engaging discussion about Brightspace Lessons.